Senator Robert Wright-Jones, and I'm here standing in support of the Eminent Domain's initiative petitions that are being certified by the Secretary of State as we speak, and on behalf of the abuse of power that Eminent Domain represents at this point. It's a fearsome weapon. It is wielded against the few by the many. It's a perversion of our government as we know it, and we should be building up communities and not tearing them down. We are all standing here together against this misuse because it threatens our individual dream of home ownership. Communities that we can build by trust among our neighbors, where we live, where we work, where we play, where we raise our children. Eminent Domain threatens our democracy. Home ownership and the knowledge that we choose to live where we want to is one of the bedrock beliefs of our country. But what happens when the will of the people has been overruled and the use of this legal procedure designed to build infrastructure in our neighborhoods and communities is used to steal our homes and our dreams? For the benefit of the few, so many of our citizens have been betrayed by their loss and have lost faith in our government. There is no democracy unless we have faith in those that rule us. As someone who believes deeply in our democracy, and I'm standing with those who are battling and fighting this perversion of our government, we don't live in an illegal society. There is not a land owned by a few and a small group of families who are subservient to them. We are entitled to our property. We are entitled to peaceful enjoyment. We are entitled to manage our future in our own homes. I stand with those who stand with the powerless, the voiceless on this issue. I stand with these opponents of Eminent Domain. We are asking our government in the initiative petitions, which will be certified by the end of the month, to be on the ballot in November. We're hopeful that those things will occur, that we can put into our Constitution some very tough language with teeth that will give the homeowner some backbone and some statute to stand on in maintaining their home. We recognize, of course, that there are infrastructure changes, things that will happen that benefit us all as a public. That's roads, that's bridges, that's transportation, that's railroads. We are not speaking about strip malls and private development on the homes of those of our citizens who stand here with me today. Hearing none, I have a piece of paper in my hand that evidently is either being passed out or it's being mailed or whatever about my vote for the land assemblage bill. And if you have any concerns about this paper at all, just give me a call at 314-664-1000. I'm more than happy to explain to you what this vote meant and what the intent of this legislation was before it was very radically changed to not support the people in the city of St. Louis. Are there any questions? Seeing none, thank you so much for visiting us today, and let's look for our victory on August 5th.